No taxpayer wants to hear they owe the IRS back taxes or are in tax debt from an IRS audit, a tax return mistake, or simply because they haven't filed yet. And there are many situations where that can happen. Even though 3 out of 4 people get a tax refund each year, that means 1 out of 4 owe. Owing tax is a fact of life, and the amounts can pile up fast, especially if penalties or interest get involved, or worse, multiple years are in play. Today I'm breaking down how to navigate the complexities of back taxes and tax debt. Back taxes are a relatively recent liability, and tax debt is generally older and typically larger unpaid taxes. And there are generally 3 levels of back taxes and tax debt. Level 1, you owe this year, and can start an installment agreement if you cannot pay it up front when it's due. Level 2, you owe back taxes. Either you filed prior years and owed money, but you didn't pay, or your payments were slow, or you never filed at all. You can either start or update an existing installment agreement, or just file your taxes and pay them. But you owe older taxes. And the 3rd level, you have tax debt, which means you've received letters from the IRS stating they will apply a levy or a lien, or in some cases, they already applied a levy or a lien. Generally, you owe tax debt, and the IRS is starting action on you. Some additional things to know on back taxes and tax debt. Tax debt can occur when you are unresponsive or when you haven't been paying your back taxes. Whether you've ignored the IRS's notices or stopped paying your back taxes or installment agreements, you will begin to enter debt territory. Tax debt and back taxes include interest and penalties on the balance owed. An installment plan can be used to pay back taxes in full, and currently the IRS is working very closely with taxpayers to help. So don't panic. If you owe taxes this year and you can't pay, you have many options and alternatives to satisfy your tax liabilities. State rules are much clearer and unfortunately stricter when it comes to collecting tax debts. Most states have more stringent rules and are largely more aggressive, especially these days, as state budgets are pretty tight. So if you owe a state, you need to manage that situation carefully and quickly, and usually along with the federal situation. For some people, if you owe back taxes, you can get yourself on an installment agreement or update your current one to include new considerations. Especially during the pandemic, the IRS has made it easier by extending the amount of time to pay and made it easier for you to reach out and update your previous installment agreement if you have one. If you owe money, you owe money. You can call it whatever you want, a pickle or a potato chip, but it doesn't matter. And owing the IRS, or the state, or worst case, owing both can be a problem. But you do have options, and you do have rights. You don't want back taxes to become tax debt and then enter into collections. Luckily, Jackson Hewitt can help with our Tax Debt Resolution Services team. Learn more at jacksonhewitt.com. For more helpful tax tips, like this video and subscribe to our channel.